Hi, I'm Duff McKagan, and you're watching Planet Rock. Yes, I would turn it down. You know, of course, Brad Pitt would be me. Or like a younger Kirk Douglas, cleft chin. Who would play Slash? What's his name? Benicio Del Toro. That would be pretty good. He'd be good Slash. Yes. That's what I'll go with. Yes. Well, we've already written, written and recorded 10 or so new songs with Jack and Dino, producer in Seattle. It was extraordinary. It's not a one, I wouldn't imagine it is a one album band. That's not the intention. So the other night with Friday and Saturday night in Cape Town, Slash and Matt and I and Gilby and Miles, we did Night Trains. I don't play that song very often, and we played Sweet Child of Mine, which is a song I don't play often at all, and played it at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And you realize some of these songs just hold some weight. There's some weight to them. In Paradise City, we played that the other night. That song's always near and dear to me. The chorus of that song I wrote even before I moved to LA. So I had it on this big piece of paper, this big pad, artist pad that had like lyrics and stuff I would draw. And it reminds me of that artist pad I had, like playing that song and the move and the drive and living in this crappy little apartment and kind of breaking out of that and people like singing that song back. You know, it's quite a journey to get from an artist pad to people singing the song back to you, like 80,000 people. Pretty incredible. So it kind of reminds me of that journey. I mean, there's so many good memories that far outweigh anything that's bad. They were like, you know, some of the best memories are selling out the Troubadour for the first time. Selling out a club in LA, that's a big city. And our little band sold out the Troubadour, famous club. And I remember that night, I remember everything about it. Coming to London for the first time and playing, not just one, but I think three nights at the Marquee, and people kind of starting to go crazy. I mean, the Marquee is small. It's like 200, it was 200 or 250 maybe. But selling it out three nights, and you would think it would be like the huge stadium shows would be the typical answer for a guy like me to give. But it was really the smaller things that, like, the when we kind of realized, like, whoa. Music is music to me, and whether I'm playing for five people or 25,000 people or more, it's still that same thing. You're doing it for I never did it for the money, so you would get used to the roar of an audience. Of course, when Guns got as big as it got, all I ever wanted to do was like play small places again, because you always want what you don't have. Right now, like, I'm in the middle of doing both. But I don't have to get myself psyched up. Play for 200 people in a packed room, sometimes it has a lot more energy to it than the bigger places, because the people are right up on you. So I like them both.